Today is the feast day of Saint Lutgardis. She is a Flemish saint who was born in Tongres in Belgium. Therefore, she is also known as Lutgardis of Tongres. She entered into religious order at the age of 12. During her life, various miracles were attributed to her, and she is known to have experienced religious ecstasies. Saint Lutgardis was born in 1182 and appears to have been frivolous as a child. She entered the Benedictine monastery of St. Catherine near Sainte-Claudin when she was only 12 years old, not because of any vocation, but because her dowry had been lost in a failed business venture. She was attractive, fond of nice clothes, and liked to enjoy herself. For young Lutgard, as for so many other women of her time, the cloister represented a socially acceptable alternative to the disgrace of unmarried life in the world. She lived in the convent for several years without having much interest in religious life. She could kind of come and go as she pleased and received visitors, both male and female, in the parlor. It was in the parlor of the convent that she had a vision of our Lord showing her his wounds, and at the age of 20 she became a Benedictine nun. Some of the nuns predicted that her change in behavior wouldn't last. Instead, she became even more devout. Over the next dozen years, she had many visions of Christ, Our Lady, and several saints. Saint Robert Bellarmine relates that Pope Innocent III appeared after the pontiff's death to Sister Lutgardis to thank her for the prayers and sacrifices she had offered him during his reign as Roman pontiff. Sister Lutgardis experienced ecstasies, levitated, and dripped blood from her forehead. She refused the honor of being made abbess. However, in 1205, she was chosen to be prioress of her community. In 1208, at Irres, she joined the Cistercians, a stricter order at the advice of her friend, St. Christina the Astonishing. The nuns there spoke French instead of Flemish. She could not learn the French language, and as a result, she experienced a loneliness and a solitude. With the advent of the nearby founded friars, disciples of St. Francis and St. Dominic, the white nuns, as the Cistercian nuns were called, they supported their preaching by prayer and fasting. Sister Lutgard was a friend and a mother to the early Dominicans and Franciscans, and was called the Mother of Preachers. Sister Lutgardis was one of the great precursors of the devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. She received a mystical stigmata on her heart while our Lord appeared to her. He offered to grant her whatever grace she wanted. She asked to know and understand Latin. Her mind was instantly filled with the riches of Latin hymns, but she experienced a painful emptiness. Our Lord appeared to her again, and she asked him to return her gift and exchange it for his heart. Christ then reached into Sister Lutgardis and removed her heart and replaced it with his own, at the same time hiding her heart within his breast. During this time, she is known to have shown gifts of healing and prophecy and was skilled at teaching the Gospels. For the last 11 years of her life, she was blind. She experienced a vision where our Lord informed her of her death. She died on June 16, 1242, the day after Trinity Sunday. She was 64 years old. She is the patron saint of the blind and the physically disabled. Predicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.